The latest release of SSMA includes a ton of new features. In this episode, we'll dive into the new conversion reports this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, we're continuing our Migrating to SQL series, and we have two very special guests joining us today. The first is Alexandra, and she's been on the show before, but Alexandra, thanks so much for joining us. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Hi, Anna. Hi, everybody. Happy to be back. I'm Alexandra, and I'm a program manager in the amazing team looking over heterogeneous migration. The focus for us is to build the right experience and tool for customers looking to migrate from DB2, Sybase, MySQL, Access, and of course, Oracle to Azure SQL and SQL Server.
Awesome. We are excited to have you on the show, and I think you're exactly the right person to be talking about SSMA, which we'll get into in a moment. And we also have Stephen joining us today for the first time on Data Exposed. So Stephen, thanks for joining us. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Sure. Thank you for having me. So my name is Stephen, and I am a software engineer here at Microsoft. And of the many great tools that Microsoft provides for database migration, I work on something called SSMA, which we've discussed or has been discussed on the show before. Specifically, recently, I've been working on modernizing our reporting experience, and that's what I hope to show to you all today.
Awesome. Great. I think we have two great guests today. So let's get right into it. I wanted to start by kind of talking about SSMA reports and asking you, Stephen, you know, why are these reports important?
Sure. So typically when you have a database working really well on a source like, say, MySQL or Oracle, and you're looking to migrate to a cloud of, say, SQL Server, you want to make sure that everything that used to be working is going to continue working the way you expect when you're now on SQL Server. So one of the first steps our customer typically takes is they run an assessment report, which should give a detailed breakdown of what SSMA will automatically convert, and what will require some manual intervention. Someone will have to go in and assist in the migration process. So that's why it's important. It's typically the first step, and it provides a big oversight.
Awesome, cool. Yeah, it sounds like a very important piece if you're gonna do this migration to understand like how the conversion is gonna go and what you might need to address. So Alexandra, this has been around for a long time. I'd love to get your take on like what existed or used to exist and kind of like some of the challenges that led towards some of the enhancements we're going to talk about.
Well, definitely. And in order to do that, we are going to take you a little bit in the past. So this is already a familiar interface for people watching our show. We made a little bit of context switching. So instead of HR database, we are looking at MySQL, at Seculum. We don't want to be boring for you guys. So we thought about changing that. And how do we get to reports from here? So that's pretty simple. You either have this amazing button on the top of the screen, or as always, right-click, create report is going to save the day. So it's just going through these objects, and at the end, you will have this amazing report, which is not that amazing, actually, because you'll have these tables. Now, out of this report, users were really interested in the navigation structure, where we have a pretty comprehensive tree displaying the parents for the child and also the child. For example, here I have procedure as a parent, and then I have all the procedures in the converted objects. Another area of interest for our user is the lower part of the pane. And errors were often interpreted as exceptions within the migration process. Well, that's not quite true. Errors are not exceptions in the tool. Errors are code or objects that we could not automatically convert and that would need some manual intervention from you. It can be either rewriting that function completely or certain parts of that code. You can go through all the errors that we have here. Now, in terms of conversion, would this block the deployment of my project? And the answer is no. You can deploy your project even if not everything is automatically converted. The piece of code that we couldn't automatically convert is commented out in TSQL, and you can address it either, of conversion type, and we'd really prefer that you do that, or even later after you deploy your project. The next section is warnings. What are warnings about? Warnings are things that we could automatically convert, but you might want to review that conversion and make sure it lands with the expectations that you have from that feature. So that's another section that you may want to review, and it may require a little bit of input if you'd like to change the way we have converted those objects. Last but not least is info. If during the conversion, in order to support certain functionality or simulate certain functionalities on the target, we add a column or we add more details regarding, for example, here, the conversion to numeric, the string literal was actually converted to numeric literal. So these are information that you may want to review for FYI and make sure that you know about it if you want to have a look later on. And then we have the big centerpiece here. Customers usually were looking at the first part of the row, and these were total number of objects, the automatic percentage conversion, and also the number of objects that were not converted. There's a lot of valuable information inside these charts, and we would like to sort of display that in a user-friendly format that could be leveraged by our customers looking for those two things, the manual effort and the quick wins on the automation. So with that being said, I'm going to store this picture in the SSMA Museum, and I'm going to pass it over to Stephen to show you what we are building for the future.
Sure thing. Thank you, Alexandra. So now that you've seen what the reports used to look like, let's show you the next generation, the brand new and improved SSMA reports. So when you first open up a report, the first thing you're going to be greeted with are these nice charts in the center of the screen. And we're going to go over what this means. On the left-hand side, we have object conversion, which breaks down the objects categorized by the highest severity of issue in that object. For example, we have an object that, let's say, has info, it has a warning, it has an error. This will be classified as an error object because that's the highest level of severity. So as you can see right here in our database, we have 8 automatically converted objects. We've got 12 objects that have an info message attached to them, only an info message. We have 1 object where the highest conversion message attached is a warning, and 14 objects over here are have errors attached to them. Okay, so now on the right-hand side, however, we have a little different view, and we have manual conversion time. This is a breakdown of how your conversion time will, essentially how much time you'll spend in each category, okay? So for example, what we do is we estimate, if you're a frequent user of SSMA, you know that we provide rough estimates. It's not exact, but it's generally a way that you can approach and find out where the majority of your issues are. We provide an hour estimate. So in this case, we could see that about 63% of our time, or 13 hours, will be spent on errors, whereas about only 7.5 hours will be spent on warnings. So if we click on the warning section of the pie chart, you'll notice that we are now navigated to the warning tab in the messages pane. Likewise, you know, if we were to say click on the info, we would be navigated to the info section. So what a user may want to do in a case when they have a lot of error objects, in this case, it's not too many, a user may wish to filter by clicking on the tab. They can filter in ascending or descending order. We will just keep it right now in descending order. And that right there may help you determine where you want to start and where you want to begin your migration journey. So these are the first two pie charts. Scrolling down a little further, we see these bar charts. So these bar charts show the children of the object. So in this case, we're dealing with a database. The children of this database are functions, procedures, tables, and views. So this provides us an overview of what is going on inside of tables, views, procedures, and functions. So at a first glance, you might look at procedures and say, you got a lot of problems in procedures, 100% have errors, that's really bad. But a further look will show you that there's only 3 objects. And if we say, let's look at tables, we could say, okay, 8 objects. So we have more objects with errors in the tables category. And so that's where I'd like to begin. So I can navigate to the tables category by clicking on tables. And I will now be brought to the tables object, which shows a very similar overview to what we had just previously seen. Let's say I want to drill down even further. And let's say I'm only concerned with our error objects. I can now filter through these error objects and see, okay, this conversion message has an estimated 6 hours, and I can see which tables inside this category, inside this tables folder, have this conversion message attached to it. So in this case, I see that there's roughly 2 hours or two conversion messages inside this table. I can click on this, and I will be navigated directly to the code where the conversion happened. So as you can see on the left-hand side, we have the MySQL or the older database, and we have our SQL Server on the right-hand side. And as you can see, there's this big block of code that's commented out. Okay, that is what we were unable to convert and would require manual intervention. So we also said that we had two errors on this object, and you can see that down here, we have two errors. We can cycle through these errors by using these navigation buttons. So as you can see, we were on the previous error. Once we have dealt with, addressed, or just acknowledged the first error, we can now move along to the second error. So with that being said, that is typically how a user would start to analyze their database and start to figure out where they may want to deal with. Another notable feature that we did add, and I will bring some attention to, is the tree view. Now we display estimated hours next to the object name. And so this can be helpful just in showing you where you might want to focus your efforts. Like I mentioned before, we only have three procedures, 1.5 hours. Not a very big deal compared to the problems that I'm going to have in tables. So that is a brief introduction to our latest SSMA reports. And that's typically how you use it. Yeah.
Wow, that's really cool. I mean, I like how you guys showed us, you know, kind of where you were and now where you've gone. And it's really amazing. You have drill downs, you have more insights into time, you have more insights into solution. I also loved kind of like the debugging way of looking at errors, how you kind of go through each of them. So really cool. Definitely something I think viewers are going to want to check out. Alexandra, I had one question for you. You know, SSMA is a suite of a bunch of tools. Is this something that's going to be available across all of them?
Oh, yes and yes. The code base is basically the same. So we'll expose all this nice, rich pie charts in all versions of the tools. And customers who are looking at the total effort, don't be scared. You can automate part of those part of that effort by leveraging the Fix Advisor tool in SSMA. So if you have the same error in multiple objects, you just need to fix it twice, and then the Fix Advisor is going to pick that up for you and reduce that time considerably.
Wow, that's pretty cool. And that's also like a nice kind of tip, because yeah, even myself, I was like, oh man, that's a lot of time you're gonna have to spend fixing it. But it's nice to know that if you fix it once. What was that called? You said the Fixer tool?
Fix Advisor. That's a machine learning based functionality. It's pretty cool.
Awesome. Cool. Well, this has been an awesome episode. I personally learned a lot. I know our viewers are going to learn a lot. Thanks so much, Alexandra and Stephen, for coming on. This was really great. Loved the demo. Loved going to see the museum and then leave the museum behind. To our viewers, thanks so much for joining us. If you like this video or are starting to play with SSMA, especially this new conversion report, then please leave us a comment. Let us know what you think. Like the video. Subscribe to our channel. Check out the whole series on migrating to SQL. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.